Just a quick note, an earlier version of these sites had callout boxes separated into their own sections, like you see on screen. This is what is shown at certain points in this video. These have since been included with the rest of the advanced sections, and they are the same callout boxes that you learned about in the Content Editor course. To demo adding content to a landing page, I'm going to start by making a brand new one. So here I'm going to go to Content, Add Content, and click on Landing Page. Before we continue, I want to note that everything on here except for the title is optional. That means each component available to you doesn't have to be used. You can mix and match sections to create what you want. At the top here, we have the title field. As you can guess, this will be the title of my landing page. It is important to note that you do not want to change the title of the front page of your site, but any inside landing pages like this won't matter as much. For my title, I'm going to put Explore Our Campus. The very next area is the breadcrumb coloring. If I switch over to my alumni page, you can see the area at the top contains the menu breadcrumb trail. This is the trail of pages that lead here. Right now, alumni is a top-level page, so it just lives under Home, Alumni. Jumping back to my editing interface, I'm able to select the color I want this area to be. For reference, the alumni page is a dark teal. To provide that nice full-width photo at the top of my landing page, I need to add to the slideshow. First off, my picture requirements are the same 1600 by 900 that are in effect on basic pages. However, instead of uploading an image this time, I'm just going to select one of our pre-uploaded stock images we have available on all of our sites. Of course, you can upload your own 1600 by 900 images. Now, just uploading an image won't create our info card that you can see right here on the alumni page or on the very front page of the site. For that, I'm going to switch back to my editing interface. At the top here, I want to check off Display Text. This is very important. If you don't have this checked off, nothing will show up. Now that we're actually able to add our text, sliding down to the Slide Text section, I can add a title such as Check Out Our Campus. And a short description. So, interested in visiting Ohio State? Get in touch to schedule a tour. Underneath these fields, I have the option to add up to 3 buttons. As a reminder, for internal pages such as About, I can start typing the page name and select the page from my drop-down menu here. For external pages such as NPR, the main Ohio State site, or even Google, I can copy and paste the URL. So for Google, I already know that it's https://www.google.com. However, for any other more complicated URL, I can just copy and paste that into there. For emails, I'm going to type mail to : and then the email address. So for this one, I'm going to add ASCWebServices@osu.edu. And finally, my link text, which is just going to be Contact Us. And I can continue to add up to 8 slides to the page. To remove a slide, I can simply click on the 3-dot menu next to Collapse and click Remove. If this is the only slide on a page, you can still remove it, and this will just ensure that you have a shorter form to work with. We also have a description for the page. Now, this provides a small tagline or a description of your site. Mostly, this is going to be useful on the front page, but you may find uses for internal landing pages as well. For this one, I'm going to put "Welcome to one of the world's most high-tech campuses." Another small area underneath that can be used to display a row of short statistics about your site are the fun facts. If I flip over to my front page, you can see that I have a string of numbers and descriptors that showcase some interesting facts about my unit. Switching back to the editing interface, if I want to add these, I can just place my number in the field here and add the descriptor underneath. And I can add up to 3 stats in a row. Now, important, just like the slideshow, to remove fun facts, I can simply click on the 3-dot menu next to Collapse and click on Remove, which is what I'm going to do for this page. So if I save my page right now, you can see I have the beginnings of my landing page. Now that we've completed this topic, choose the next video on the right side of the screen, or view the entire playlist with the link on the left.